Hello friends, in our organic chemistry name reaction section, today we are going to learn a new name reaction, that is Mac-Mooney coupling reaction. So Mac-Mooney coupling reaction, first we will see the principle, then reaction, then mechanism and application. First we have to see what is the principle. Olefination of carbonyls. What is the meaning of olefination? Olefins are compound possessing double bond. Compounds possessing double bond, right? Means alkenes. So we are going to prepare alkenes from the carbonyls. Alkenes from the carbonyl with low valence titanium, such as titanium zero. Oxidation of titanium taken is zero. That is called low valent titanium, right? Derived from TiCl3 with along with lithium aluminium hydride. So if you take the TiCl3, the actual oxidation state is plus three, because number of ligand are three and the power minus one. So oxidation state of TiCl3, titanium is plus three. If we take with the reducing agent, say for example lithium aluminium hydride, it will get reduced to titanium zero. And that we will use as a catalyst, and the whole reaction process, the mechanism is like free radical mechanism. Single electron transfer process. Single electron transfer process. So what we get from this principle, in Suzuki, Hiyama and other four reactions, we seen that a new CC bond formation, new CC single bond formation in the molecule. But in this reaction, we are going to learn about CC coupling, but with multiple bond, with double bond. So preparation of olefication will happen in this Mac-Mooney reaction. Now, what is the reaction for Mac-Mooney reaction? So you can see any aldehyde or ketones, in short, carbonyl compound, in short, carbonyl compound. Our focus area is what? Carbonyl. The R1 and R2 may be any attachment which can generate either aldehydes or ketones, but focus area is carbonyl. In presence of TiCl3 along with the lithium aluminium hydride, follows some mechanism, and finally after hydrolysis, we will get some new CC double bond formation. New CC double bond formation. You can see carbon which we drawn here. In the carbonyl is taken in, suppose say for example, either for 2 moles, or you can say take 2 different carbonyl compound, will form new CC double bond. New CC double bond, right? That is in the Mac-Mooney coupling reaction, right? Why coupling? Because CC bonds are formed, new CC bonds are formed. So that's why it is coupling reaction, right? And titanium oxide, after mixing both, it will get converted into Ti zero oxidation state, will be removed as titanium oxide from the reaction. So how this reaction is happening, that we can understand by the help of mechanism. Now let's see the mechanism part. So mechanism, it will start from the reduction of our catalyst. TiCl3, as you see, here it is already mentioned, the oxidation state is plus 3. Oxidation state is plus 3. When it reacts with the lithium aluminium hydride, which is the reducing agent, so plus 3 gets converted into 0 oxidation state. Converts into the 0 oxidation state, right? And that we are going to use as a catalyst in Wall reaction. See, the carbonyl compound. Carbonyl compound get broken in such a way due to the catalyst titanium zero oxidation state in such a way it follows the single electron transfer free radical mechanism. So here if you see very carefully, the half arrow is drawn. Half arrow means a single electron transfer. If you have doubts about the free radical and the ion mechanism, just go to my YouTube channel's playlist. GOC playlist is there in my YouTube channel. Okay, very basic fundamental organic chemistry is mentioned into that. You can learn from that. Here one electron will be transferred to oxygen and one electron will be transferred to the carbon. So now oxygen have one free electron, titanium have one more free electron. So one electron will be shared to each other. So formation of a bond between the titanium and oxygen will be there. Now this carbon possess one free radical. Carbon possess one free radical, which is already in single electron form, right? Same way, another molecule of carbonyl can also follow the same. So you may have two free radicals. One free radical will make a bond with titanium. The carbon will have one free radical. Another carbon will have also one free radical, right? Now, a process of homocoupling. Process of homocoupling means what? Same molecule. If you taken two moles, it will couple with each other by free radical mechanism. How? One electron from here, another electron from here. Both will be shared to form a new covalent bond. Both will form a new covalent bond, right? And that is here. You can see, yeah, a formation of new CC bond. A formation of new CC bond will occur, right? Now, this CC bond is already formed. But here, the bond between oxygen and carbon will again break by free radical mechanism. So one electron will be transferred here, one will be transferred here, right? So titanium already possess one free radical. Now oxygen also get one electron, so also possess one free radical. So a bond formation between titanium and oxygen will be there. That will be removed as titanium oxide. Now we have another bond also with oxygen and carbon. This will also break down in such a manner, it will follow the single electron transfer. So one electron from here will be transferred to oxygen, another electron will be transferred to the carbon. So new free radical formation on this carbon and one oxygen. One electron is already present in the titanium, so that will form another bond. So here titanium oxide, another molecule will be removed. Right? So we have a titanium oxide. This is called oxide coated titanium surface. So removal of TiO two times, right? But if you see in the previous mechanism, we prepared a free radical by breaking of this bond. One more free radical will be generated. So here one also free radical, here also one free radical. So now what will happen? This will share its electron. This both will share one electron for the formation of a new CC bond. Right? So by that way you can see a double bond is formed. One bond was already present, another formed due to the both free radical present on each and every carbon. So this is called olefin. Right? Here the starting material is taken in two moles. That's why we get the both same side around the double bond. But you can also take two different carbonyl compounds, reacts with titanium zero, generated by the reaction of TaCl3 and lithium aluminum hydride. right? And you can get according to the product, according to the product, right? So this is the base mechanism how the McMurray coupling reaction is happening, right? So this is about the mechanism. Now we will see the application part. As I told, if you take the different two carbonyl, you may have a product like that. So let's see the application. See, here the carbonyl, you can see this is a ketone. This is a ketone. One part, another part, right? Carbonyl compound, which is different from this compound, So if you see, both are carbonyl compound. Both have the carbonyl compound. Catalyst taken as CaCl4, and zinc is taken for the reduction purpose. Right? And now the reaction of these things will give us a new CC bond formation. Right? So it is taken from some recent paper, and you can see the reaction giving us a new CC double bond formation, that is olefination. So this is the one example for the McMurray olefication coupling reaction. Now we will see another homocoupling. You can see two different carbonyl, here same carbonyl two times, right? So that will give us a formation of new CC double bond. That's why this is known as McMurray olefication coupling reaction, right? So this is the another application of same reaction. Now, thank you very much for listening me patiently. We will again meet in a new video with new name reaction. Thank you for listening me patiently. Have a great time. Thank you. Stay subscribed in my channel and forward this videos to your friend who can also learn free education.